taking a look here at Stephen A's top five teams in the NFL last week. Number five, Packers. Four, his Steelers. So disrespectful. Saints at three, Bills at two, Chiefs at one. What changes this week? Mr. Smith, go ahead.
Well, there's always changes because the list is mobile. It's week to week, things change. You ain't married to anything until come playoff time. During the regular season, you got to generate interest. Let's go to number five on my list, please. Who do I have here? The Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Why? Because I got a quarterback in Tom Brady that's completing about 66% of his passes. I got a defense that's number one against the rush and number three in yards allowed. I got an offense that's got Leonard Fournette averaging over 4 yards a carry. Ronald Jones averaging over 5 yards a carry. I've got Mike Evans. I got Chris Godwin. I even got some dude named Scott Miller. And also I got Antonio Brown and Gronk. I'm sorry. I'm looking at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers making amends for that blowout loss to New Orleans. Definitely in the top five. I got to give it to them. Let's go to number four on the list, please. Give it to me, y'all. The Los Angeles Rams. Why? Because even though you look at Jared Goff, and obviously he's had his troubles this week, Robert Woods has been playing well, Cooper Kupp is there. Obviously, I'm looking at their three-headed monster running the football relatively effectively, but that's not the biggest thing. This team is a top two defense in the league in points allowed, in yards allowed. Don't get me started with what we saw Jalen Ramsey do to the great DK Metcalf just a few days ago, and we know what they can do against the run as well. The Los Angeles Rams are one of the elite defenses in the National Football League with Sean McVay handling their offense. I'm sorry, I got to give love to the Los Angeles Rams. Let's go to number three on the list, please. Give it to me, the New Orleans Saints. Why? Because even after a cracked rib and a collapsed lung, Drew Brees still went out there and threw 2 touchdowns. Last time I checked, even though he's going to be out for a few weeks, we got Alvin Kamara. You got Michael Thomas. You still got Emmanuel Sanders. You still got Sean Payton calling plays with Jameis Winston and Taysom Hill that he could utilize at the quarterback position in a defense that is far better than just respectable. And we saw what they did to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. At this moment, they are a top three team in the league. We got to give love and respect where it's due to the New Orleans Saints. Number two on the list, give it to me, my team, the Pittsburgh Steelers, undefeated at 9-0. Ramrodded Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals, just like I told Max they would do. I like Joe Burrow. He's got tremendous promise. But T.J. Watt had to let him know, excuse me, this is the AFC North. Welcome to the North. This is how we do it. This is how it goes. The Steelers are undefeated. Got one of the elite defenses in the game. And in case anybody's missed it, Big Ben Roethlisberger is playing like an MVP candidate in the National Football League, even when COVID-19 has him quarantined for the week and he's missing practices. Still shows out on the field and shows out. The Steelers, the only undefeated team in the National Football League, are number two. Can't give them number one, though, because it's still that dude Patrick Mahomes in Kansas City with the Kansas City Chiefs. There's still Tyreek Hill on the squad. There's still Travis Kelce on the squad. It's still Mecole Hardman and Sammy Watkins. It's still Andy Reid and Eric Bieniemy calling plays with a respectable defense. We can't take the Kansas City Chiefs for granted and just summarily ignore them because of their greatness. We understand who they are. We understand that everybody has to go through them. You might have to go through the city of Pittsburgh, but to get to the promised land, you're going to have to go through the reigning, defending Super Bowl champions who, by the way, are just cruising under the radar to some degree, ain't worried about anybody. Those are my top five teams. Okay, the Bucs, Rams, Saints, Steelers, and the Kansas City Chiefs.
You know what? You've had some sorry lists recently, but this is a good one. The only gripe I have is the placement of the Rams. And even that, I understand what you mean about the fact that they have a defense and everything, but here's the problem. Their last four games, four weeks ago, they lose to San Francisco when they have Jimmy G. They beat Chicago in a tough, close game where Chicago really had no O-line play at all. They lose to Miami starting a rookie quarterback. I know it was Tua, but still, and he didn't put up big numbers or anything. And then they just beat Seattle. They're 2-2 in their last four with a couple of losses in games that a top four team probably should have won. Other than the Rams, I probably replaced them with the Packers. I agree with the list.
Oh, Man, Max, you and I are reading the same sheet, man. Listen, Stephen A., to your credit, this is the best list you've had since I've been busting up on your list. So this is a solid list by you. I respect it.
I'm in agreement with
Max on the Rams because, hey, here's one other issue with the Rams. Their left tackle, Whitworth, just went down with a leg injury. Yeah. I think it's 4 weeks or something like that. That's a big loss for this team. We talk about Breeze when he gets hurt, right? We talk about, like, this is a big miss for that team. Not only is he a decent, I mean, he's a good run blocker. He's an excellent pass blocker. That's the blind side of Goff. And we know, listen, that's the iffy part. I would put the Packers at 5, the Bucks at 4, and the Rams at 6. But I like the list. I think it's pretty solid, Steven. Hey, you should take some pride in this list, man. This is like A-minus list. You know what I mean?
Hold on, Max. First of all, I take pride in all my lists. Secondly, I've never had a sorry list. Don't know what the hell y'all talking about. Thirdly, when you talk to Whitworth, well, that's next week. Because remember, the list is mobile.
It's fluid.
It's week to week. It's a mobile list.
Yeah,
so I'm allowed to do that, okay? Let's keep that in mind. Let's understand that. And, oh, by the way, the reason I didn't have the Packers necessarily on that list or whatever, I'm looking at the Rams right now, Jeff Saturday, and I'm telling you, this defense is elite. It's big time. And that's why I believe they belong on that list. I can't rely on Green Bay's defense the way I can rely on the Rams' defense. Remember, when they lost to Miami, that's because Jared Goff stunk up the joint with 4 turnovers in the first half.
Mm-hmm. Well, remember
they held Tua to 93 yards passing and Miami to 55 yards rushing. Their defense did their job.
They're 2-2 in their last 4. They have 2 losses and 2 wins. I don't know if they deserve to be number 4, even if you wanted to put them 5. Remember when Whitworth was a free agent?
Look at that defense.
Teams like the Giants passed on him because they thought he was a little bit old to be getting guaranteed money over years. Whitworth has been one of the best free agent signings by any team in recent years. He's absolutely key to the Rams' success.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.